There was a time when the Chicago Bulls dominated basketball. Jordan took them to unprecedented heights, winning 6 championships in 8 years. It's been hard to replicate that success again, but a few seasons ago, it seemed like they were back. Yet, they failed again. From high hopes to unexpected setbacks, the Windy City has seen it all. Hello and welcome back to NBA Swish. Today, we're going to be talking about what in the hell happened to the Chicago Bulls. I know you must have a lot of questions. How did they botch it again with their star-studded team? And why did they have such heavy expectations laid on them? Well, stick around till the end as we answer these questions and more, as we delve into the various details surrounding the problem with the Chicago Bulls. Without further ado, let's get into it. First, we gotta start at the beginning. Before COVID hit, the Bulls were under the management of the duo of Gar Foreman and John Paxson, which was nicknamed GarPax. This reign was immensely unpopular as the team struggled no matter what the management did. The pair had a track record of questionable trades, significant missteps, and strained relationships with players and coaches. However, things changed after COVID, and the Chicago Bulls underwent a much-needed transition, ushering in a new era under Arturas Karnisovas. As you can imagine, this was welcomed by the fans. When he took over as general manager, he went to work with a clear vision for the future. He took over a young core that included Zach LaVine, Lauri Markkanen, and Wendell Carter Jr., all in their early 20s. Just imagine inheriting such a talented young team. This strong foundation and the possibility of future draft pick selections gave Chicago hope for a brighter future. It almost felt like the Bulls were finally heading back to their glory days. And just to say that he was quick with his dealings as the manager is an understatement. Arturas was bold. He established his imprint with daring and aggressive moves just a year into his tenure. For example, in March of 2021, the Bulls acquired 2-time All-Star and dominating offensive center Nikola Vucevic from the Orlando Magic. This was the first of a few moves that began the shift in the Bulls' transformation, and to be honest, he was on the right path. Vucevic's offensive skill is the missing piece of the equation. With career averages of 24 points, 12 rebounds, and 4 assists, the stakes were high, and fans were eager to see how this decision would affect the team's fortunes. But what do you think happened? Comment down below. Although, I'm sure many Bulls fans know exactly what happened with him. Let me give you an overview. While many fans might not have realized this, Vucevic made things worse. The deal cost him a first-round pick, which Orlando utilized to choose Franz Wagner, a potential young superstar. Wagner would have been a far better, younger, and hungrier player than Vucevic could ever be. And moreover, the Bulls also had to deal with injuries, mostly to Zach LaVine. So it wasn't surprising that they finished a measly 11th in the conference that season. It was apparent. More changes were needed to make a difference. Vucevic was not enough. The following season, Arturas could have done better in addressing critical needs. He did strengthen the backcourt by bringing in Lonzo Ball, known for his great playmaking and defensive abilities. He also engineered a trade to bring in Alex Caruso, a tough-minded defender with a propensity for spoiling rival offenses. Caruso's tenacity and basketball intelligence were praised, and he rapidly became a fan favorite. The arrival of these players signaled the team's commitment to strengthen its perimeter defense and ball movement. Because you know what they say, defense is the best form of offense. After finalizing the defense, the team started focusing on offense. And that's where the addition of DeMar DeRozan comes in, a regular All-Star noted for his mid-range prowess. DeRozan's scoring skills and clutch performances made him an intriguing addition. Yet, others questioned his fit in an NBA that emphasized three-point shooting in the current era. However, he proved everyone wrong with his greatness. Overall, these moves were pretty good considering the circumstances, especially given that none of the players were signed to max contracts. So while we can give them credit for the rebuilding, it's also true that they could have done much better. Surprisingly, despite all of the signings, the following 2021-22 season was a roller coaster journey of promise and heartbreak. The season started strong, with LaVine, DeRozan, Ball, and Caruso all shining. Their tenacious defense, led by Ball and Caruso, stymied rival offenses. While LaVine's scoring and DeRozan's mid-range prowess provided offensive potency, injuries, however, took their toll on the squad, forcing Patrick Williams and, finally, Lonzo Ball to miss the whole season. Ball might not be rated highly, but trust me, he was terrific with the Bulls. After his injury, the team's defensive ranking dropped, and their campaign was marred by inconsistency. Despite a hard-fought triumph in Game 2, the Bulls' playoff run was cut short by the Milwaukee Bucks. Given the lofty expectations, the postseason exit disappointed fans. Arturas was limited in making team changes in the following offseason. This was because he had used all of his cards the previous season and needed more resources for more signings. Despite re-signing Zach LaVine, the Bulls started the 2023 season with similar players, prompting questions about their ability to compete in a rapidly shifting Eastern Conference landscape. They had to do something before they failed yet again. And well, hope emerged with the midseason arrival of Patrick Beverley. His energy and defensive zeal revitalized the team's identity, reminding them of their earlier season form. Chicago's defense improved, providing perimeter assistance for Alex Caruso and improving the overall team dynamic. Many might rate Pat Bev less highly, but his stats could be more accurate. His presence makes a huge difference. Thanks to the signing of Beverley, the Bulls ended the season on a high note. However, they still had yet to make the playoffs and were trying to qualify via the play-in tournament. Things were going well as the Bulls surprised the Toronto Raptors by making a late-season push for the play-in tournament. However, their postseason hopes were shattered in a close game against the Miami Heat, the future Eastern Conference champions. This raised concerns about the team's future as it dealt with aging stars, limited draft assets, and prospective roster changes. The team has found itself at a crossroads, needing to make critical decisions in a league that requires a delicate balance of patience and strategic planning. After so many years of struggling and investing in the squad, things do not look good for the Bulls. So now we've discussed their timeline, but not what in the hell was happening in Chicago, which led to their recent downfall. Well, a lot of factors come into play. The Bulls' aging players are one of their more glaring problems. DeRozan, a four-time All-Star, is already 34 years old, and there's questions about his long-term viability and as a leader in the locker room. Furthermore, while Zach LaVine remains a dynamic scorer, his injury history makes his future contributions unpredictable. And these players are their stars. So, as you can see, their current roster could look better. The Bulls lack significant first-round picks due to bold moves made in the prior seasons, leaving them with few alternatives for infusing new talent into the squad. Considering these factors, the Bulls must decide their next course of action. Do they opt for a full-scale rebuild, parting ways with their star players in exchange for valuable draft picks, or do they attempt to retool and complement their existing core with strategic acquisitions? Whatever path they choose, the Bulls face an uphill battle in a competitive Eastern Conference. The decisions coming up in these coming seasons will undoubtedly shape the franchise's trajectory and determine whether they can rise from their recent disappointments to contend again on the NBA's grand stage. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.